Hi everyone, you're back with us here on The Spot, and we're going to go straight into our spot of music with our once special guest. He came through on our third anniversary, the lovely Kobams Asukwo with MT.
I'm swimming against the current, swimming against the current. I think I need you. I need
you. Know, the thing about Kobams is that you can't help but love him.
Yeah.
Like, you just can't. The guy just oozes so much talent.
Yeah.
As a musician, as an artist, like, even the thought that goes behind his videos are always thought provoking.
Wonder If People was so good. That was a great video.
Yeah.
So this one, I guess, is kind of echoing the
empty
song,
the empty,
the emptiness and all that kind of stuff. Yeah. I feel like people think of him in one way.
In one way.
You know, and he's really, really multifaceted. I think I was mentioning during the break, he did a remix of Skin Tight,
Mr. Easy,
featuring Effia, and he did a remix. I don't know where I heard it. And I was like, oh, I need that.
Was it like a ballad?
It was, no, he just jumped on it, like the actual song. He didn't change it. He just added his own bit. And he was like, yo, I heard it and it was so tight. I said, ah, is this you, Kobam? I said, hello. I was like, okay. And it was so dope.
Yeah.
And I think we tend to maybe put him in a box. Oh, it's Kobam, so he's going to do all soft, kind of like, you know, ballady kind of music. Although he's really, really great at that as well. So, yeah, so this is kind of a bit of a minimalist video, that much activity.
Imagine if
Kobams
had a video that was like gra gra. That would be so scary.
Gra gra, so like,
as in like,
your
popping, and then, you know, I know.
Yeah, I think he loves
my heart would drop.
Your heart would drop. I think he just, he loves songs that lyrically, because
this doesn't even take away from the music, man. Like, you can still hear it, you can feel it.
Is that Sika?
No, it looks like her.
Looks
even
so much
visually.
Like Sika.
Yeah. Well done.
I like the very sort of, I like that black and white, like I like these little effects, like the visual, it's visually striking. Let me see, that's especially this part, the black and white. So. Dope. I'm looking forward to his album coming out. I'm looking forward to like more performances, more like, you know, all these little small,
intimate
kind
yeah.
of, yeah, I really like to see a lot of that. I would definitely go and take part in that as well. Awesome sauce. Alrighty.
Yeah.
It's time for our guest to come in.
Okay.
And she is an actress, she's a producer, she's an on-air personality. If you see her face, I know you know her. Let's welcome the lovely Tana Egbo Adelana.
Come on in!
Blinging. I said it before, I like this top.
It is very
nice. I feel like maybe
nice.
You should just leave it here. Maybe.
Really?
Just maybe.
Please
just maybe.
Share with us as to who you got it from.
Oh, yeah.
How are you?
I'll tell you.
Welcome.
Is it like ready to wear or did you like
uh-huh,
ask
ready
them
to wear.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. That's nice.
Very, very nice. Got
a fantastic designer.
Yeah, blinging. Okay.
Thank
blinging.
You.
Life is good. 2017 is good, as we can see.
I know, life is treating you well.
I like it here.
Thank you.
It's really
thank
nice.
You. Yeah. So what have you been up to? How is 2017 treating you?
Ah, fantastic. It's been great.
Yeah.
I've been working. I've been shooting, well, for the last part of 2016.
Okay.
Till now.
Okay. What have you been shooting?
Movies.
Ooh, uh-huh. Anything coming out soon?
Well, yes. I can't remember all the names, especially because most of
been
them...
that many? Okay.
And because most of them are working titles, so we can't really tell what the exact names would be. But yes, I have been shooting for a couple of producers.
Yeah, cool. So you act, you produce, you know, you do quite a few things. Which one do you feel like is the one thing that you probably just wouldn't want to give up? Is it the acting? Is it the producing? Is it the presenting?
First
stuff?
Of all, I love TV presenting.
Okay.
It's my first love, well, apart from modeling.
Yeah.
I love TV presenting. And I think as a TV presenter, you're also an actor and vice versa. So basically, I can't leave anyone.
Cool. What projects are you working on for this year? Like, are you doing any of your own things, like where you're producing and doing
No. I don't know if I want to produce this year. It takes a lot, you know.
Yeah.
And the industry has kind of moved, you know, we're not where we used to be before.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are not ready to produce,
Don't try it. Because the
water. I mean, right now, I know what I want, you know. I think I have it all written down in my little book of work, whatever it is I want to do.
So what is the plan? Is it just strictly movies or?
If it comes, if it's good, I'll do it, whatever it is, mm-hmm. presenting, you know, or acting, whatever. But I don't want to produce this. I don't think I want to produce this year, mm-hmm. even if I'm going to. It's going to be the later part of the year. Mm. Not right now.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And your, so the work that you've done, mm-hmm. do you feel like you, every time you get a new project, you want to top the last thing that you've done?
Of course.
Is it like, okay, because like, I feel like sometimes, I know that we've had lots of guests on here who say that they don't always get the quality of work that they wish they could. So they'll get a really, really great script for like a, you know, maybe a drama or a movie. And they're like, this one won't be as whatever, but maybe things are not really coming as much. So that's what I'm trying to figure out. Like, what do you look for mostly? Like when you get some work or you get a script or something, what do you look for? And you're like, okay, yes, this is it. It's, instead of this one, I'm going to pick this one.
First of all, as an actor, you know, you're not always going to get that script you're looking for all the time. But you can make whatever script you get really great, you know, especially if you have a good director, mm-hmm. they have good equipment, location, and the job is not, you know, sometimes if a job is too stressful, it mm-hmm. takes a lot. It takes a lot from you.
Okay, mm-hmm.
From your performance.
Okay.
So, yes, if I get a script and it's nice and then I, you know, hear the name of the director, I do my research, I've mm-hmm. seen the kind of jobs he's done or she's done and, you know, they're good. Yeah, then by all means, I'll jump on it. Mm-hmm. Okay. So basically, as long as the script is good and, you know, the director
is not a crazy person.
And the producer also knows what he or she wants, you know, it makes life easier.
Yeah.
And then also your co-actors.
Yeah.
Because you also want to, you know, totally. Be in a movie with people who understand the craft, mm-hmm. you know, not the people that, you know, they can't even get lines. Mm.
It becomes very stressful. Teamwork definitely is necessary.
Exactly.
You need a
teamwork.
Good team.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, on that note, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll get into it with our topic of the day. We'll see you guys in just a moment. Hi, guys. Welcome back to The Spot. And today's topic is titled The Power of Thought. I can't remember who said this. Maybe it's in the Bible. Thoughts become things.
Yeah.
And I remember listening to a sermon once by T.D.
James.
when he was saying that everything begins with a thought.
Yeah.
The kind of dress you decide to wear when you make up in the morning, if you choose to have a bath or not have a bath, if who you choose to talk to, how you choose to go to work, everything starts with a thought.
Yeah.
And he was just trying to emphasize how powerful it is, what you think and how much control it has mm-hmm. over your internal and external factors.
Yeah.
So for me, recently I've also been talking about the essence of visualization.
Mm-hmm.
So when you think a thought and you visualize it,
mm-hmm.
and you kind of visualize it into existence. So you picture yourself, so let's say if you want a new job, you'll picture yourself every single day going to work, wearing your uniform,
mm-hmm.
and sitting in that desk for that new place that you want. And somehow it reinforces it to the point that you go for it and you attract it.
Yeah.
So I don't know, I want to know what you think about thoughts attracting things.
Yeah.
Do you think it's possible? Does it exist? Or is it just all a mental play?
Well, I don't think it's all a mental play. Mm-hmm. I think it actually does attract whatever it is you're going to become. It controls who you are.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the way you react to people, your actions, mm-hmm. everything. So it kind of like makes you like who you are.
Who you
just
are.
Yeah, it just arranges your entire life. You know, if you say, listen, if I go out today, I don't want to talk too much. I don't want to, mm-hmm. you know, play too much. I want to be very serious. And then you go ahead and do it. You see that you attract a different kind of people towards you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's true.
Yeah, you attract.
It's true. Like
The vibe just changes, the energy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm. I mean, I remember actually having a similar kind of discussion with someone and saying, you know, I notice that on the days where I really am in a solitary mood, I don't have to say to anybody in the office or wherever I go that I don't want to talk today. I just noticed that people just don't really come around me mm-hmm. because the vibe around you is just, you know what?
Is it the vibe or also the appearance?
No.
Well,
the
everything.
What you, because I mean, let's say your uniform is a black suit every day or a suit and, you know, and a pencil skirt or whatever, I don't know. It's not like what you look like. It's this vibe that you're giving off. It's people sense it, your aura, whatever it may be. It's not like anyone is seeing it. It's not like you said anything to anybody. It's not like you shouted or yelled. But they just kind of, whatever energy is about you, they kind of feel it. And that's because...
And it all comes from your thought process.
Yeah, because you really just are having that sort of, you know, today is just not the day. I just kind of want to be in my own space. I just kind of be in my own mode. I want to focus on this, this, that, and the other thing. So I just don't really want to mess with anybody today. And you will find that a lot of times, that vibe will make sure that people kind of, they might come for, they might be like, oh, okay, oh, hi. Where they will sit down before and have a 5-minute conversation with you, they'll be like, well, maybe not today, hi. And then they just go by.
And to buttress, so. And to buttress what you've said, also, if you realize that, with age, obviously, comes wisdom.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Not all the time. And then you see that, listen, I want to reevaluate myself. Why is it that people react to me this way and not that way? And then you think about yourself, your life, how you've been, and how you want to be, you know, and then you just realize that if you change your thought process or you change the way you behave, people just react to you differently.
So that whole changing the way you think, I think it sounds easier said than done. Like, I'm the kind of person that if something happens that maybe I'm not happy with, I chew over it and I mourn it until I'm done with it. For another person, they might be able to just switch it on and off like that. And I always say that I think that the mind and the body needs to be allowed to feel what it needs to feel in order to just, like, process. I guess it's different for different people. But how hard or how easy is it to change a mindset? Let's think about Nigerians.
It's not easy.
And the way
it's
we are.
So difficult.
A lot of things affected. You know, where you grew up, you know, the kind of people you've been relating with for a long time all your life, you know, the kind of home you were brought up in, you know, and then the friends, the experiences you've had, the friends you've kept along the line, the kind of jobs you've done, the results you've gotten from all of that. It's not easy, but, you know,
I think
it's not easy at all.
It's one of those things where actively, it's the hardest thing to change how you think. It's actually, because it's almost, we don't think about how you think.
How you think.
No,
it's just something
think,
we do.
Right? So when you're thinking one way, for you to, and you've thought one way
adjust
for 20
or even
years, 30 years,
think about our parents, right? Mm-hmm. So when they were growing up, you know, nobody was trying to be a singer or a rapper or anything. Like that. So then your child comes and says, I wanna dance for a living. And it's like,
you.
Like what? But we're going to go on a quick break and talk about that a bit more when we come back. We'll see you guys in just a moment. Welcome back to The Spot, and we were talking about, well, our topic today is called The Power of Thought, and earlier on we were talking about how hard it is to change your thought process, and I referenced parents, and I remember one of our family friends...
Get you some water?
Yes, please.
One of my mum's, like, really good friends, her daughter, we're the same age, and when we were going to college, you had to pick your, uni, you had to pick what subjects you wanted to major in. So she decides that she wants to do performing arts. So I remember the day my mom came home and was like, I just spoke to Sherry's mommy. Like, she looked so depressed. I was like, what's wrong? She's like, would you believe that? Sherry's gone to learn dancing at university.
And she let her.
And she let her.
Oh, gosh.
I said, look, performing arts is more than just dancing. And it's not like she's just... Like,
she's not just standing on here doing like
and dancing all the time. There's theory, there's coursework, like there's history and stuff that they have to learn
about.
It's not
too cold though.
And I said at the end of the day, this is what this child wants to do. Mm-hmm. But she just couldn't fathom that
somebody
that would be normal
dancing.
For you to I have learn. A similar story. Because when I wanted to, well, it was time for me to go to university, I wanted to study theater arts. Well, actually from secondary school, it was a taboo in my place to say, I'm going to arts. when you get to secondary school, like senior secondary.
Yeah.
Because you do sciences, okay. There's a commercial, and then there's art. I wanted to go to the arts class. My parents wouldn't let me. My dad said, hell no, no child of mine will study arts. I'm like, daddy, are you... I said, have you seen me? Do I look like a scientist or a doctor or a lawyer? And I'm like, okay, no problem. I did my sciences, but then I took classes in literature. I did literature classes.
Okay.
So, in government, just so that
I could balance.
Yeah, could balance. They didn't know. They found out I was taking government. I had to drop the class, but I stayed in literature.
Okay.
So I did that. After, when it was time for my jump, I begged. They said, no, hell no. My dad wanted me to be a medical doctor. My mom wanted me to be an engineer.
Wow.
So it wasn't, yes. And I couldn't pass chemistry for the life of me.
No, I
had a very good result. Like, I had literally 7 A's in my result and like 2 B's and 1 C or something like that. I can't remember exactly what it is. But my chemistry was a pass. It just didn't work.
But it's, for them, is that something that we, especially with the way things are changing and younger people are now
creative.
Seeking to, to run towards their dreams and stuff like that. Is the thought of the older generation something that has to change, that we have to change?
Or? I don't think we necessarily need to change it anymore. It's changed already. Because
yeah.
I finished, I still couldn't study theater arts. Okay. I went ahead to study what I wanted me to study.
Mm.
The only course I could find, urban and regional planning.
Mm.
I enjoyed it anyway. I did that. I gave them their certificate and I moved on.
Mm. But the thing is, you see, this is why I feel sometimes that sometimes it's just so, because if you had studied your theater arts,
yeah.
It's not to say that you wouldn't, you obviously you're doing what you want to do now, mm-hmm. and that's great. But those years you spent,
exactly.
learning, time is something you can never get back. You would have flourished in an environment where you really felt passionate about it. You would have learned maybe the theory of, so apart from, learning on the job or something like
and
that.
And now taking extra courses.
And now taking extra courses. So you could have used that time. So that's one of the things that sometimes I just find. So I find that sometimes maybe they definitely do need to change the way they think about certain
There's
things.
There's no need anymore.
There's no, yeah. Well, now people just do what they want, to be very honest. Kids just do what they want.
And parents of nowadays.
You just complain as much as you want. My dad's birthday, I don't know how this conversation started, but I feel like it had something to do with my parents. I just remember being called downstairs and my uncle said he wanted to have a chat with me. I'm like, this whole law situation, with media and entertainment, there's a glass ceiling. But with law, the ceiling, there's no ceiling there at all. It's just open. So,
I know.
So then what he does, he calls his son, who happens to be like a lawyer elsewhere. He was like, just speak to him. He will advise you. He was like, okay, give me your number. Let me just, I was like, it's okay. Like,
I'm not doing it.
Like, we've actually gone past that stage now.
I think with, the power of thought, it works for certain things, but I think that it works when you also add work to it. You must do the actual work too. I can't sit down all day and think, I'm going to be famous.
And you're not doing anything about it.
And it's going to happen.
You also have to put in that work, right? But yes, I think
how many of our people now want to work?
Now that's another problem. A lot of young people these days, I think it's just...
I think it's the likes of, their peers or people that I guess they admire making it look as easy.
Yeah.
So it's like, is it not just act and read something?
Oh, try.
Or the new fame, so some people are social media famous.
Right.
Or the people that they like are maybe like reality TV stars or somebody who came to fame.
Not by virtue of work.
They're more infamous than they are famous because they did something they
terrible.
Made a tape or they did something.
Just take off your clothes and then, voila.
But that's not it. Please, don't say we told you that is it. But we're going to go on another break, guys. When we come back, we have more for you here on The Spot. Please stay with us. You're still watching The Spot, guys. Welcome back. We've been talking about the power of thought with the lovely Tana. And before the break, did we have anything pending?
No.
Okay, I just wanted to talk about or mention, have you read the book The Secret?
No.
Okay, so this book, is it says, you know, it really is about thought and visualization and how, you know, something as simple as you're going somewhere and you're hoping for a parking space when you get there, right? Something as simple as that. If you visualize getting there and seeing an open parking space, even though it's a place
before.
Where, oh, you have? And you just visualize driving in there and you believe that more likely than not, when you get there, there's going to be a parking space for
well,
you.
Well, I've tried that. It didn't work.
I tried
maybe
it once when
believe.
I was...
Maybe you didn't believe.
Oh, now I have to believe. Okay.
Yes, now.
Not just,
I was
okay.
going to... Oh, where's that place in VI? Churchill? Is that it? Where they do where all the airlines are or something.
Oh, no, I don't know.
They do like all the visas and stuff there.
Oh,
it's always packed.
Yeah.
So I went around the first time. I didn't find a parking space. And I the second time I went around again, I was like, Lord, I'm going to find a parking space.
Did you?
And there it was. Just waiting for
Trust
me,
that has nothing to do with your thoughts.
Are you sure?
Yes. Someone finished
and left. And your timing was good. That's the thing. I think with people talk about it. I remember, well, not arguing, but having a bit of a debate with someone I know that doesn't believe in any of this stuff. It's all mumbo jumbo. It's all heebie-jeebie. It's nonsense. I'm like, why are you so angry? People let them believe what they want to believe, but really he believes that all of it is just like people want to attribute success, but any kind of achievement to some kind
something,
of
something,
you know something,
yeah.
And sometimes it's just because
it's like,
it was the right timing, or you knew someone,
like,
or you did something.
No, but when you do what do they call them? Those drug trials.
Oh, when you
and you get the placebo,
yeah.
Right? And some people do survive or get better because. Ultimately, it is the mind that they program themselves into thinking, I am getting better.
Yeah, that's true. One of those things, I remember reading something similar to that where they were talking about how they gave two sets of people with like migraines a drug and then they
placebo.
Gave the other ones a placebo. And mm-hmm. they gave, it was sort of the similar results. So the people who took the placebo, because they felt like they had taken something, they started to feel
better.
Like they were feeling better.
Really, really it is
so
the mind.
Sometimes, you know, I think the mind can, you know when you say your mind's playing games on you,
mm-hmm.
sometimes that might be it, you know, yeah. All right, well, we're gonna do a quick switcheroo.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna check out somebody who has put not only her mind, but her work into, you know, what she does. So let's check out Tasala HQ, working it.
My name is Dupe Talabi, and I'm the head stylist of Tasala HQ Hair and Beauty Salon in Free Lagos. We offer a variety of services and treatments for clients who come into the salon. From when they come in, we do a consultation to decide on what the best course of treatment is for them. And then once that's decided, their hair can be washed, the treatment applied, and then the suitable styling service carried out. For natural hair, we do a lot of protective hairstyles and maintenance styles, such as finger coils, straw sets, Ghana weaving. We do weaves, we make hair pieces as well. We also make wigs, we make custom wigs for women. We design wigs based on what they want and to suit their lifestyle. A typical day in the salon starts with the salon opening by 10 a.m. We look at what we have planned for the day, what clients are booked in, and what services are due to be rendered that day. We also have walk-in services who sometimes just want to come in without booking. We offer services for them based on how busy we are. I think our selling point at the moment is the attention we pay to detail with our clients and with the work that we do. You know, every client is special, every client's service is tailor-made to their needs. So we make sure we pay attention to that and deliver service way above and beyond expectations. The challenges that we have are things that are very easy to handle. Most of it comes down to client relations and dealing with staff and just relating to them in the way you want them to work. We are located at AP Shopping Complex on Bank Road in Ikoyi, Lagos. You can also connect with us on Instagram. Our Instagram handle is @TasalaHQ. You can also go onto our website, which is www.tasalahq.com. And we're also on Twitter, handle @TasalaHQ. 5 years from now, I would like to believe that Tasala HQ would be a household name brand, both in Lagos, in other parts of Nigeria, and other parts of Africa as well. I would like to, you know, possibly expand to other parts of Nigeria. Also, we're very passionate about education, and that's something that we want to drive forward and move more into. So I see us being more, possibly having a training school as well.
I actually know her.
That's Lamide's hairstylist.
Listen,
so tell us.
Of, actually, so, I haven't been there for a while.
So tell us, how's their customer relation?
Awesome. But no, she's just someone that I know that's very passionate about what it is that she does, and she does put a lot of thought into, you know,
the process,
the way she wants her business to be run and the way she wants things to do. And that's something that I actually wanted to mention. Like, I think that when you say power of thought, I also think of planning, mm-hmm. right? I think of where you want your life to go, right? I don't think a lot of people spend time thinking and putting a plan together, like, okay, it's February, it's March of 2017. This month, this is what I really want to achieve. And spend a lot of time just conceptualizing, okay, these are the things I really want to achieve this month. And not vaguely, as in, this
intensely,
is the step I'm going to take to do this, and then I will do this, and then I will do that. So I think the power of thought also comes into it where you think about your life.
First.
And you plan out, okay, this is where I want to get to. Fine, that's the destination. What is the route? What's the best route? What's the way I'm going
to... Which brings us back to what we're talking about, young people who mm-hmm. just want to get famous
now,
and rich,
want
just like that.
Now.
I mean, for every successful person, I know sometimes they all come up with all these stories, oh, I did this, I did that. I know it's a lie. But what I do know is that they put in a lot of work.
Yes.
And they think it through. They know this is what I want to do. If I go this way, mm-hmm. you know, I'll probably get there.
Yeah.
Sometimes it works. Mm-hmm. I mean, actually, most times mm-hmm. that works. Mm-hmm. But they're not with the details they give us.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
well, they don't. Yeah,
that's because they've got to give you a nice package.
Who never tell you the true story?
The true
that
code code of the story.
They're just like, oh, yeah, I prayed, and then one day. You're like,
no, you didn't just pray, no. And that didn't just, no. It didn't happen like that, no. Just tell me the truth.
Yeah. Are you a planner out? Like, do you plan all these things? Like, you know, you just say...
What I do know, hard work always pays.
Yeah.
It takes a while, but it pays.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's some really good advice.
Yes.
We're going to take a quick break now. When we come back, we've got a social media roundup for you, and we'll be rounding up the show. Stick around for that.
Welcome back to The Spot. We're going to check out what we've been, you know, going through on social media and share it with you. This is all from YouTube.
And, YouTube?
This is all from YouTube.
Oh, that's nice. Hello, YouTube.
YouTube, when we finally put up those episodes, they're very happy. But so this is actually, anyway, his name, 2009, said, the male presenter, okay, we're talking about Timini, it was an episode with Timini Ebuson. The male presenter, please wear your shoe. You guys are representing Nigeria. Come on, guys. And then we didn't have to fight for ourselves because why? Sharp Techno came to the rescue and said, it's laid back. It's not a corporate setting. You for cuckoo tell and make you wear suit and tie now. And that is what made me laugh. I was like, people are battling for us. Thank you, Jerry. Sharp Techno. May your techno always be sharp.
Amen.
All right. And then Oyodime said, y'all should have Sisi Yemi on your show and also Toke. These are young people doing well for themselves. Bring them on, you. Ebony Life TV, you should also bring more celebrities both in Yoruba and English movies. Okay.
Okay.
Well taken. Toke is very busy with her book, and she also does moments. So, you know, when she's done with moments, she don't got time for y'all. She don't got time to do all this stuff. She's doing a lot of stuff at the moment, but we'll try and see if she can fit us into her schedule. And Sisi Yemi is, Sisi Yemi is coming.
She is?
Yeah, I believe she's coming. Or has she? Yeah, she's coming. And we'll see who else we can get. A lot of times, I think people are just so busy, especially with Yoruba movies, because it's almost like you're shooting back to back to
it's
back
to back.
It's
not just Yoruba movies. Everyone is working.
Everyone is working. Everyone is trying to work as much as they can, too. So, but, you know, we'll do our best to bring in a lot more varied guests. Thank you very much for your feedback. Yes.
Awesome.
Awesome sauce.
Should we share a sweet spot?
Sure.
Okay, so every episode we like to share a pet peeve or a sweet spot, something that we really, really love. And I think Lamide has a sweet spot
Fantastic.
Today.
Fantastic. Great.
My sweet spot today, really, it does kind of have to do with the subject, okay. with the topic of the day. It is when a thought that I've had, like something I've been thinking about, mm-hmm. comes into play without me necessarily. This is what makes it sweet for me. Without me necessarily working for it. Like if I've been thinking, oh, I would really like to meet, I don't know, Sonny Ade, I don't know, something. And I don't make any calls. I don't ask, oh, who knows him? Well, who can get me backstage? You can do da da da. And I just somehow happen upon him, or he just or something like that. Like that makes me happy. It's usually smaller things, right? So it's not like a huge, I want $8 million, although I do. But when I've been thinking about something that, oh, this would be really nice, and it just happens sort of by chance, I like it. It makes me happy because I'm like, oh, somehow the universe, God conspired to kind of make my little thoughts come into life. So that's my sweet spot for the day. Do you have one? It could be anything. It doesn't have to be related to the subject.
For me, mm-hmm. okay, my sweet spot is when I plan something okay. and it just works.
Because mm-hmm. then, Niger, yes.
traffic, yes. you know, people and their crazy notion and ideas about how things should be done,
yeah.
and you know that this is not how it's meant to be. It's mm-hmm. meant to be the other way. If I plan and it happens, I mean, I'm very happy.
Yeah.
Especially with the kids, with the family, yeah. front everything. Yeah.
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
How is that? How is the
family life?
It's great.
Oh, look at the smile.
It is great. Oh, my son, by the way, he wrote Common Entrance and he came tops in year 5.
That's congratulations. What's his name?
Toby.
Congratulations. That's her. You're right.
You see, are you serious?
Are Toby. We're
but then he's not going to go to secondary now.
Why? Is he too young?
Yeah, I think yeah. so. He's very intelligent, mm-hmm. no doubt. But I think, you know, like we're talking about thought and planning and everything. Mm-hmm. I think you have to have a certain level of maturity to yeah. get into secondary school.
Yeah.
Because I don't want him being bullied.
Exactly.
I don't want him falling into the wrong crowd, right. wrong hands, and not being able to control mm-hmm. his thought process because he's too young and they're
yeah.
way ahead
yeah,
of him.
People are now manipulating and all that kind of stuff.
You know, my husband and I spoke about it. Yeah, he's passed. I know he's going to pass it again next year.
Yes,
yeah.
Totally.
I'm sure he will. Oh, congratulations to him. That's pretty cool. Yeah. You also look way young to have a kid that's doing Common Entrance, just so you know. And I know you know. I know
well,
you know.
But am I that young? Well,
you look it. See, this is the thing. When you say black don't crack, like you could still be peddling. 27, girl. I'm 27 for like
They'll
the next
never
five,
know.
6 years. You know
yes,
what I'm saying?
I know. So that's great. It's fine. Yeah. I'm enjoying it.
Good stuff. All righty. Mm. Well, it's time for us to round up on the show today. It's been pretty cool.
Time.
I hope you've had a good time.
Yes, I enjoyed. I don't want to go.
Thank you. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Toodles.
All righty. So please sign our wall. We
now
have our
that's
little
a
chalk.
New dab, isn't it? Let me do.
Chalk is right there on the in the blue, and then you can just write.
Why did I decide?
Because it's bad for you.
It's bad for you.
Thank you.